I can't hit the switch. Hey, what's going on? Amalgamate. It's like a super... It's a super dog. Let's play with the super dog. Amalgamate is not excited enough to play with? What the? Amalgamate is watching you intensely. Or intently, rather. Okay, let's excite you. Beckon. You call the Amalgamate. It bounds towards you, flecking a strange liquid from an orifice. Oh, this time it is actually moving! Hovering close, looking for affection. Okay, let's pet you. You pet the Amalgamate. It convulses rapidly, then calms down. It rests quietly on your lap for a moment. Suddenly, it shoots away and crawls wildly on the walls. Amalgamate is striking the wall with its claws. Play? You throw your weapon into the corner of the room. The Amalgamate brings it back to you. Proudly? You repeat this process a few times. Now Amalgamate is very tired. It leans its dripping, amorphous body on you. Whew. Twitching affectionately. Still not ready to go, huh? Does it need to be even more tired? Play again? Seems too tired to play. Oh, dang it, that didn't do anything. At least this attack is super easy to avoid. So, pet it? You pet the Amalgamate. It starts to generate a stage 1 happiness froth. Ew! Convulsions intensify. Oh my god, please, please, keep petting. You pet decisively. The Amalgamate seems to be satisfied by all this. Oh, look at all the kitty cats in between the legs, or something. Endogeny is contented. What? Okay, bye. You won. The hell was that thing? So, I'm guessing that got rid of the fog over here. I don't actually know if it did, but I'm hoping. Ah, it did. I already read this, right? No, I don't think I did. No, I couldn't read it. The families keep calling me to ask when everyone is coming home. What am I supposed to say? I don't even answer the phone anymore. Empty. Samples. Whoa, that one's moving. Asgore left me 5 messages today. 4 about everyone being angry. 1 about this cute teacup you found that looks like me. Thanks, Asgore. It's empty. That's not empty. What are you talking about? It's moving. Can I, like, push it over or something? I guess not. I spend all my time at the garbage dump now. It's my element. Hey! It's so cold. You look vaguely like the ice dragon thing. You are the ice dragon thing. How did I fight the ice dragon thing? It's been so long. Something about its jokes. I think I need a joke with it? Told a bad pun about snow. Her expression starts to shift. Haha, I remember. That's it? Smells like salty slush. This thing is so sickly. laugh. You laugh and keep laughing. It's so funny, you can't stop. Tears run down your face. What? You didn't do that. Snowy. Heckle? You said something like, you look horrible. Why are you even alive? What? You didn't say that. Laugh again? But it's not funny. No, it's not funny. This thing's so sad. Spare? No, it doesn't want to do anything. What am I supposed to do with you? Joke? Her expression changes more. Oh, it likes it. It wants me to tell jokes. She's completely calmed down. Good, I made it happy. Now what about this one? Still says it's empty, huh? I'm gonna heal myself just in case. I could just regenerate at a save point, but eh. Although, wait, I have to head down to where the save point is anyway, don't I? I do. Oh well. We'll need a vessel to wield the monster's souls when the time comes. Wait a minute. Is that what Flowey is? Was Flowey the vessel for the monster souls? And then obviously the experiment went wrong. After all, a monster cannot absorb the souls of other monsters. Just as a human cannot absorb a human soul. So then, what about something that's neither human nor monster? That is Flowey! That is Flowey! Golden flowers. Yep. Experiments on the vessel are a failure. It doesn't seem to be any different from the control cases. Whatever. They're a hassle to work with anyway. The seeds just stick to you and won't let go. Okay, you look like astigmatism, sort of. Right, what did I do to astigmatism? I think I just... Wait, no, you're a combination between astigmatism and the flying thing that I pray to, so let me try praying. Whatever its name is, remembers its conscience. That's two creatures combined in one. What are you doing? Oh god. Are you okay? Pray again? Already remembered its conscience. Okay, that didn't do anything. Yeah. Pick on? It seemed effective. Ugh. Keep picking? It was already picked on. Alright, I guess don't do the same thing twice. Mystify? Reaper Bird seems to remember something. Reaper Bird? I thought this was just two creatures, but it looks like it's at least three. Oh, there we go. I'm gonna go back to restore my health. Cold, that's all I could read. Okay, already done that. It should be everything. Hey, wait a minute. Can I sleep in this bed now? No, I can't. And I swear there must be something you can do with this dog food bowl. Maybe it's just because you encounter that, the dog-cat creature? Maybe that's the only reason it's here, but I feel like there's something you can do with it, but I don't know what. Seems like another elevator has lost its power. Turned off. Is this the soul-sucking machine? Seems like this controls the elevator's power. Turn it on. This thing looks demonic. I think if I turn this on, I'm gonna, like, suck up the soul of every damn monster or something. I feel like I'm gonna kill a lot of things if I turn this on, but I guess I don't have a choice, so sure. Please soak them up. Please soak them up, machine. Hey, stop. I got you guys some food, okay? Sorry about that. They get kind of sassy when they don't get fed on time. Anyway, the power went out, and I've been trying to turn it back on. But it seems like you were one step ahead of me. This was probably just a big inconvenience for you, but I appreciate that you came here to back me up. As I said, I was afraid I might not come back. But that's not because of these guys or anything. I was just worried that I'd be too afraid to tell the truth. That I might run away or do something cowardly. I suppose I owe you an explanation. As you probably know, Asgore asked me to study the nature of souls. During my research, I isolated a power I called determination. I injected it into dying monsters so their souls would last after death. But the experiment failed. You see, unlike humans, monsters' bodies don't have enough physical matter to take those concentrations of determination. Their bodies started to melt, and lost what physicality they had. Pretty soon, all of the test subjects had melted together into those. Seeing them like this, I knew. I couldn't tell their families about it. I couldn't tell anyone about it. No matter how much everyone was asking me. And I was too afraid to do any more work, knowing everything I'd done so far had been such a horrific failure. But now, I've changed my mind about all this. I'm going to tell everyone what I've done. It's going to be hard. Being honest. Believing in myself. I'm sure there will be times where I'll struggle. I'm sure there will be times where I screw up again. But knowing, deep down, that I have friends to fall back on, I know it'll be a lot easier to stand on my own. Thank you. Come on, guys. It's time for everyone to go home. Alphys really has done some horrible stuff. I've chosen a candidate. I haven't told Asgore yet, because I want to surprise him with it. In the center of his garden, there's something special. The first golden flower that grew before all the others. The flower from the outside world. It appeared just before the queen left. I wonder, what happens when something without a soul gains the will to live? I guess we know, don't we? The flower's gone. Flowey. It's a voice you have never heard before. Are you there? It's been a long time, hasn't it? But you've done well. Thanks to you, everything has fallen into place. See you soon. Where the hell am I now? Jammed shut with vines. Oh, I've been here before. This is right before Asgore. Yeah. This is the shortcut. Hold on, I want to go check on the human souls down here first. Still here. Hi? Yeah, this is the barrier. This is what keeps us all trapped underground. If by chance you have any unfinished business. Okay, this is the same as before, but surely something's different, right? What is this? Did I go the wrong way? Because so far everything is the same. Surely something should be different, right? Wait, that's different. Toriel? Toriel! What a miserable creature, torturing such a poor, innocent youth. Do not be afraid, my child. It is I, Toriel, your friend and guardian. At first, I thought I would let you make your journey alone. But I could not stop worrying about you. Your adventure must have been so treacherous. And ultimately, it would burden you with a horrible choice. To leave this place, you would have to take the life of another person. You would have to defeat Asgore. However, I realized I cannot allow that. It is not right to sacrifice someone simply to let someone leave here. Is that not what I've been trying to prevent this whole time? So, for now, let us suspend this battle. As terrible as Asgore is, he deserves mercy, too. Tori, You came back. Do not Tory me, dreamer. You pathetic whelp. If you really wanted to free our kind, you could have gone through the barrier after you got one soul. Taken six souls from the humans, then come back and freed everyone peacefully. But instead, you made everyone live in despair. Because you would rather wait here, meekly hoping another human never comes. Tory. You're right. I am a miserable creature. But do you think we can at least be friends again? No, Asgore. Hey, Undyne. Asgore, human. Nobody fight each other. Everyone's gonna make friends, or else I'll... Hello, I'm Toriel. Are you the human's friend? It's nice to meet you. Yeah? Nice to meet you. Hey, Asgore, is that your ex? Jeez, that's rough, buddy. Hey, nobody hurt each other. Oh, are you another friend? I'm Toriel. Hello. Hi. There's two of them. Hey, nobody fight anyone. If anyone fights anyone, then I'll be forced to ask Undyne for help. Hello. Oh, hello, Your Majesty. Psst, hey, human. Did Asgore shave? And clone himself? Hey guys, what's up? That voice. Oh, she recognizes, Sansa's voice from all the knock-knock jokes on her door. Hello, I think we may know each other? Oh, hey, I recognize your voice too. I'm Toriel. So nice to meet you. The name's Sans. And, same. Oh, wait, then... This must be your brother, Papyrus. Greetings, Papyrus. It's so nice to finally meet you. Your brother's told me so much about you. Wowee. I can't believe Asgore's clone knows who I am. Asgore's clone? This is the best day of my life. Hey, Papyrus. What does a skeleton tile his roof with? Snowproof roof tiles? No, silly. A skeleton tiles his roof with shingles. I changed my mind. This is the worst day of my life. Come on, Asgore. It's gonna be okay. There are plenty of fish in the sea. Yeah, Asgore. Undyne's totally right about that fish thing. Sometimes you've just got to, stop going after furry boss monsters and, just get to know a really cute fish? It's a metaphor. Well, I think it's a good analogy. Metaton EX. I guess they've been repaired. Oh my god. Will you two just smooch already? The audience is dying for some romantic action. Hey, shut up. Man, the nerve of that guy. Right. Alphys? Alphys? No. He's right. Let's do it! Well, I guess if you want to, then? Don't hold anything back. Wait! Not in front of the human. What? Right. Sorry, I got a little carried away there. My child, it seems as if you must stay here for a while. But looking at all the great friends you have made, I think you'll be happy here. Hey, that reminds me. Papyrus, you called everyone here, right? Well, besides, her. Anyway, if I got here before you, How did you know how to call everybody? Let's just say... a tiny flower helped me. A tiny flower... You idiots. Oh god, not Flowey again. While you guys were having your little powwow, I took the human souls. And now, not only are those under my power, but all of your friend's souls are gonna be mine too. And you know what the best part is? It's all your fault. It's all because you made them love you. All the time you spent listening to them, encouraging them, caring about them. Without that, they wouldn't have come here. And now, with their souls and the humans together, I will achieve my real form. Huh? Why am I still doing this? Don't you get it? This is all just a game. If you leave the underground satisfied, you'll win the game. If you win, you won't want to play with me anymore. And what would I do then? But this game between us will never end. I'll hold victory in front of you, just within your reach, and then tear it away just before you grasp it. Over and over and over. Listen, if you do defeat me, I'll give you your happy ending. I'll bring your friends back. I'll destroy the barrier. Everyone will finally be satisfied. But that won't happen. You. I'll keep you here no matter what. Even if it means killing you a million times. What? Do not be afraid, my child. No matter what happens, we will always be there to protect you. That's right, human. You can win. Just do what I would do. Believe in you. Hey, human. If you got past me, you can do anything. So don't worry. We're with you all the way. Huh? You haven't beaten this guy yet? Come on, this weirdo's got nothing on you. Technically, it's impossible for you to beat him, but somehow, I know you can do it. Human, for the future of humans and monsters, you have to stay determined. All my monster friends! Dogs in the bottom left! No! Unbelievable! This can't be happening. You! I can't believe you're all so stupid. All of your souls are mine! Finally. I was so tired of being a flower. Howdy. Are you there? It's me, your best friend. Azriel. It's the end. Asriel Dreamer. Oh my god, that's really cool. That's really cool. And nice, we got some rock music going on. Or metal. Whichever this is, who cares? It's really cool, that's the important part. Okay, wait, how are you Asriel? Asriel died, right? I know that Asriel made it to the human world and set that human down in the patch of flowers. So there's some connection between flowers, and the flower was the one that came from the outside world. But I don't... Well, anyway, whatever. This music's awesome. Just focus on that. Focus on the music and the awesome visuals. Dream or hope? Let's dream. You think about why you're here now. You can feel the empty space in your inventory get smaller and smaller. Oh god. Okay, not bad. Only got hit once. Asriel charges Shocker Breaker. This music is so cool. Hope? You held on to your hopes. You reduced how much damage you'll take this turn. Oh, okay. Okay, so if they're charging an attack, I guess I need to do that, and if they're not, then I guess do the other thing? You know. I don't care about destroying this world anymore. Oh. Calls on Chaos Saber. Whoa, last dream, what the heck are these? Through determination, the dream became true. HP was maxed out. Cool! After I defeat you and gain total control over the timeline, I just want to reset everything. Okay. Ow. Have another last dream. All your progress, everyone's memories, I'll bring them all back to zero. Whew, okay. Not bad. Star blazing. I guess we hope again. You kept holding on. Then we can do everything all over again. Cool. Let's dream again. Get some more healing items. And you know what the best part of all this is? You'll do it. Oh, oh. Oh my god, that's really confusing! Fuck, that's confusing! I think it's really easy to avoid, but... Ugh. But it refused. Oh, I didn't die? My heart can't even break. But what did that actually do? Did it just reset me to the... No? I guess I'm good. Alright, so is this the gun thing? Nope. Okay, not bad. Okay, this time I'm just gonna heal. Because this is the gun again. Okay. Oh, I see. Whoa! Wow, I still barely friggin' made it, but I get it. Sometimes you have to, sometimes it's aiming at you and you have to move just slightly. You have to keep, like, nudging, and other times it's aiming around you, so you need to not move. This music is so cool! I love it! Also, my voice is getting tired, so my voice is starting to crack. Bring it on. And then you'll lose to me again. No, I won't. Oh, right. Wow, I just need to keep healing, like, every single time. And again. Whew. Okay, let's get more healing items. And again. Galactica Blazing, that doesn't sound... Oh! You ate the snowman piece! Oh, I didn't mean to! I'm sorry! Fuck! No! Well, there's no going back now. Fuck. I'm sorry, snowman. Well, I mean, I did take them outside the first time. So... Yeah, whatever. Because you want a happy ending. I do. Although, it might not be that happy now that I ate the snowman. Oh god. Because you love your friends. I'm really bad at avoiding the blades, although they're really not that hard to avoid, to be honest. Because you never give up. God, the attacks are getting crazier. Isn't that delicious? Your determination, the power that let you get this far. That's gonna be your downfall. Nope. Didn't even take a single point of damage. Reddy's hyper goner. Guess I'm gonna be goner after that one. Let's get some more healing items. Now, enough messing around. It's time to purge this timeline once and for all. Whoa. What the hell is this? What? Oh. Even after that attack, you're still standing in my way. Wow, you really are something special. But don't get cocky. Up until now, I've only been using a fraction of my real power. Let's see what good your determination is against this. Azrael blocks the way. Ooh, you look really cool. Struggle. Can't move your body. Hurrah! Ha ha ha. Behold my true power. Ow. Mend my broken heart, thank you. Every time you die, your grip on this world slips away. Every time you die, your friends forget you a little more. Your life will end here, in a world where no one remembers you. Ugh, that's really hard to avoid. The whole world is ending. Well, that sucks. Still can't move your body. Still, you're hanging on. That's fine. In a few moments, you'll forget everything, too. That attitude will serve you well in your next life. Please don't do the same attack! I can't even use an item, so I actually can't heal myself. Still? Come on. Show me what good your determination is now. Can only take one. Actually, no, I can't even take any more hits, I believe. Ooh. What's happening? You struggle. Nothing happened. You tried to reach your save file. Nothing happened. You tried again to reach your save file. Nothing happened. Seems saving the game really is impossible. But maybe, with what little power you have, you can save something else. What? You're telling me I have to choose one person to save? No. You're gonna make me choose one person to save. I wanna save everyone, of course. I like them all. But it has to be Toriel, doesn't it? It has to be Toriel. You reached out to Azriel's soul and called out to your friends. They're in there somewhere, aren't they? Within the depths of Azriel's soul, something's resonating. The lost souls appeared. Oh no, I don't want to fight. What do I do to the lost souls? Preference? What the heck is that? Hug. You hug the lost soul and tell her that you're going to see her again. Something about this is so familiar to her. Lost souls stand there. Okay, so I think maybe that's what I needed for the Toriel lost soul. What about you? What do you need? Mercy? You tell the lost soul that you won't hurt him, no matter what. Something about this is so familiar to him. Still haven't done it yet, though. Talk? You tell the lost soul that you have to go if you're going to free everyone. Something is stirring within her. Still not quite there yet. Let's talk to the second one. You're going to save everyone. Something stirs within him. It's all flooding back. There we go. You are our future. Yes, I am. Save me. You feel something faintly resonating within Azriel. Do I need to save more? I do. Okay. Let's do Alphys next. Something's resonating. Okay. Let's nerd out. You ask the lost soul what her favorite cartoon is. She can barely hold back from giving you an enormous answer. You hate me, don't you? No, I don't. Let's encourage you. You tell the lost soul that you'll continue to support her. Something about the way you said that is familiar to her. I've got to keep lying. Nerd out again? Suddenly, the memories are flooding back. No, that's not true. My friends like me. And I like you, too. There we go, Alphys. Oh, what the heck? I just accidentally attacked. I did not mean to do that. Ow. Owie. Owie. Let's heal. Okay, 15 health. That's fine. Okay. Undying. Remember the time we cooked? You asked a lost soul to teach you how to cook. She doesn't know why, but she kind of wants to teach you how. All humans will die. Oh, this again. This is so cool! You get to like meet all your friends again and experience their attacks and stuff like that, and their personality. Fake it. You tap the lost soul lightly. Something about the way you fight is familiar to her. Clash? Clashed against the lost soul with all of your might. She recognizes your fighting spirit. Suddenly, memories are flooding back. Well, some humans are okay, I guess. Pass the spirit, Undyne. Oh, damn it! I accidentally attacked again. I think it's because the save selection is always flashing, so it makes me think, when I'm not looking directly at it, that it's actually selected already, but it's not. Alright. Who do I save first, Sans or Papyrus? It doesn't really matter, but I guess Sans. Within the depths of Azra's soul, something's resonating. Oh, cool, both at the same time. Puzzle. You asked the lost soul for help with a puzzle. It doesn't know why, but he really wants to help you. Oh, right, jumping. Don't move. Ow. I really need to heal. Recipe. You ask the lost soul to cook something for you. Lost soul is trying to hide its joy. Try the other one. It's a joke. Told the lost soul a bad pun about skeletons. Suddenly the memories are flooding back. There we go. Save someone else. I can save other people. Strangely, as your friends remembered you, something else began resonating within the soul. Stronger and stronger. It seems that there's still one last person that needs to be saved. But who? Suddenly, you realize. You reach out and call their name. Huh? What are you doing? Feel your friend's souls resonating within Azriel. I'm gonna save you. What did you do? What's this feeling? What's happening to me? No, I don't need anyone. Yeah, you do. Stop it! Get away from me! Do you hear me? I'll tear you apart! Come on, Azriel. Do you know why I'm doing this? Why I keep fighting to keep you around? Doing this because you're special. You're the only one that understands me. You're the only one who's any fun to play with anymore. No. That's not just it. I'm doing this because I care about you. I care about you more than anybody else. I'm not ready for this to end. I'm not ready for you to leave. I'm not ready to say goodbye to someone like you again. So, please, stop doing this. And just let me win. Stop it! Stop it now! I'm so alone. I'm so afraid. I'm so sorry. I was a crybaby, wasn't I? I know. You're not actually are you? Has been gone for a long time. What is your name? Frisk? That's a nice name. Frisk. I haven't felt like this for a long time. As a flower, I was soulless. I lacked the power to love other people. However, with everyone's souls inside me, I not only have my own compassion back, but I can feel every other monster's as well. They all care about each other so much. And they care about you too, Frisk. I wish I could tell you how everyone feels about you. Papyrus, Sans, Undyne, Alphys, Toriel. Monsters are weird. Even though they barely know you, it feels like they all really love you. Frisk, I understand if you can't forgive me. I understand if you hate me. I acted so strange and horrible. I hurt you. I hurt so many people. Friends, family, bystanders. There's no excuse for what I've done. I forgive you. I forgive you. What? Frisk, come on. You're gonna make me cry again. Besides, even if you do forgive me, I can't keep these souls inside of me. The least I can do is return them. But first, there's something I have to do. Right now, I can feel everyone's hearts beating as one. They're all burning with the same desire. With everyone's power. With everyone's determination. It's time for monsters to finally go free. Frisk. I have to go now. Without the power of everyone's souls, I can't keep maintaining this form. In a little while, I'll turn back into a flower. I'll stop being myself. I'll stop being able to feel love again. So, Frisk, it's best if you just forget about me, okay? Just go be with the people who love you. Nah, I'm not gonna forget about you. I don't want to let go. Frisk, you're gonna do a great job, okay? No matter what you do, everyone will be there for you, okay? Well, my time's running out. Goodbye. By the way, Frisk, take care of Mom and Dad for me, okay? Frisk, this is all just a bad dream. Please, wake up. Oh, you're awake. Thank goodness. We were so worried. Felt like you were out forever. Yeah, any longer and I would have freaked out. Tell us next time you decide to take a nap, okay? Yeah, you made Papyrus cry like a baby. What? I didn't cry. I don't cry. I just caught something in my eye. What did you catch? Tears. Now. The important part is that Frisk is all right. Here, Frisk. Why not drink some tea? It'll make you feel better. How about we give them space first? They must be very exhausted. Though, from what, I'm not certain. Frisk, we do not remember exactly what happened. There was a flower, and then everything went white. But now the barrier is gone. When you're ready, we will all return to the surface. It seems the door to the east will lead us there now. But before then, perhaps you might want to take a walk? You can say goodbye to all of your wonderful friends. Do as you wish. We will all wait for you here. Let's take a walk. I should probably save. Also, I don't know if I'm going the right way. She said to the east was... No, I think I'm supposed to go to the east a bit, but just don't keep going to the east. This is embarrassing. Hi, bye. No. That is the barrier. I thought everybody would be waiting for me outside. Am I gonna have to hunt them all down? Because that would take, like, 50 million hours to find them all. if I have to go find them all around Hotland and Snowden? Oh my god. But I can't leave without saying hi to my friends. So, let's go find them.